Hello my dear students, today in this video we are going to begin a new chapter, that is your measurement, chapter 10. So everyone, you can open your book, page number 155. So as you know that measurement is very important part, okay, in our daily life. Everywhere we use measurement, right? Suppose we are traveling, so in that also we measure distance. Suppose we are buying, you know, some clothes, so in that how much cloth is needed, okay, to make some other cloth out of it. So there also we need measurement, okay. Suppose you are drawing something, so in that also you need measurement, right? And so students, here in measurement there are few units, okay. Different units are used for different purposes, okay. Suppose for example, for weight, no, weight, to measure the weight we use either kg or gram, okay. For length we use either centimeter, meter or kilometer, okay. Kilometer is used for longer length, that means your distance, okay. And for quantity, okay, we use, this one is used for your liquid things, so liter or milliliter we use, right? So these are some different units used for different categories. In case of weight we use this units, in case of length this, and in case of you can say quantity or capacity, okay, capacity we use liter or milliliter, okay. Now see your book students, so here it is given that measure this to the nearest centimeter with a centimeter ruler, that means you have to use your scale, okay. Remember to start at the mark, at the zero mark of the ruler. So students, to measure this you need a ruler, and there you have to, if you have a ruler, so in that from zero you have to start. So you have to place the ruler and then you have to see that what is the length of this nail, okay. So after measuring I got 2 centimeter, okay. If it is not exactly that, so you can write the nearest centimeter as it is mentioned in the question. Similarly for this key, okay, I got 3 centimeter, and for this line 6 centimeter, okay. And students, here one thing is given, you see 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter and 1 meter is equals to 100 centimeter. So these terms you have to remember, okay, because later on when we will do conversion from one unit to another, so these things will be required. Now fill in the blanks. So students, you see here it is given that you have to write either centimeter, meter or kilometer, okay. So as I have already told you that where kilometer is used, okay, centimeter is the smallest here, and meter for, like, you know, for measuring some, you know, things which are, like, you know, not that much long, okay. Now you see a number, height of a sauce bottle. So it is given 15. So sauce bottle, it will be nearly about centimeter, right? So in the blank area you have to write centimeter. The length of the wall behind the school building. So length of the wall behind the school building. So it may be, like, you know, in meter, because 40 is given. So yeah, it may be 40 meter long, okay. Now the distance from home to airport, 17. So as I told you, in case of distance always we use kilometer, okay, 17 kilometer. A width of a shirt button, okay, so obviously a shirt button is very small, so in that case it will be centimeter. As I told you that for smaller here, centimeter, meter and kilometer, so centimeter is the smaller here. So obviously a shirt button is very small, so the width will be 1 centimeter. So in this way you have to write in the blank area. This one will be centimeter, meter, kilometer and centimeter. Now here it is given, match the most likely weight, okay. So as I told you that in case of weight we use either kg or gram, okay, that means kilogram or gram. So 1 kg is equals to 1000 gram. Now, encyclopedia, that means it's a book. So, the weight will be nearly about 2 kg. Sack of rice, 5 kg. Strip of tablets, it's very, lightweight. So, that means it will be in gram. And loaf of bread, so obviously that is also not that much heavy. So, it will be 450 gram. Okay. So, in this way you have to match it. Now, ring the closest measure. Okay. So, here you see condition is given milk in a cat's bowl. Okay. So, milk in a cat's bowl. Here it's given 100 ml, that means 100 milliliter or 100 liter. So, students, in a cat's bowl, it will be very small, right? So, as I told you, in case of liquid things, we use liter. Okay. You see, in this bucket, it is written 1 liter equals to 1000 milliliter. So, in case of water, in case of juices, in case of your milk, these are liquids. So, we will use what? We will use milliliter or liter. And cat's bowl is very small. So, in that case, 100 liter will not be possible, right? So that's why the answer will be 100 milliliter. Okay, you can see liter is the greater one, okay, and milliliter is smaller. So 1 liter will be equal to 1000 milliliter. So you can imagine 100 liter means so much, like, you know, it will be a large quantity. So it will not be the correct answer. So you have to ring this one. Oil in a can, whether it will be 5 ml or 5 liter. Obviously, oil in a can, it should be 5 liter because ml is very much less. Okay. Now, juice in a bottle, 1 ml or 1 liter. Obviously, it will be 1 liter. Okay. In a bottle, so you know, like the height of the bottle, it can, you know, the capacity. Hai na? So, juice in a bottle, it can't be 1 ml because 1 ml is very much less amount. Now, water in a sauce tank, water in a storage tank. So, storage tank means where, you know, that big tanker used to, is used for storing water. So, it will be 1000 ml or 1000 liter. So, 1000 ml is equals to 1 liter. So, obviously, with 1 liter, to nothing will happen, right? So, for storing, we store water in a large amount. So, the answer will be 1000 ml. Liter. Okay, so in this way you have to ring this measure. So students, here we covered all the measures, like length also, then weight also, and capacity also. Now in the next page you see it's given measure in length. Okay, so here you see we use centimeter, meter and kilometer to measure length. So in case of measuring length, we always use centimeter either or meter or kilometer. Okay, so here one ruler is given, and this see, from zero we have to start. Okay, at from 0 to 1, it will be 1 centimeter, 2 centimeter, 3, 4 and so on. Okay. So, here you see the line segment is on the line between 4 and 5. So, it is 4 and half centimeter. So, you see from 0 it is started, but it is, it is between 4 and 5. So, as I told you in the earlier chapter also, that one needle measure you have to write. So, that one between 4 and 5, so it will be 4 and half. So, it can be written in this way. Okay. And in decimal if you are writing, so that can be written as 4.5. Okay. Now, in case of this screw, so this screw is about 3.5 centimeter. You see from 0 it is started, and 3 and in between 3 and 4. So, obviously it will be 3.5. Okay. So, in this way, by using the scale, if you are not getting the exact one, like if it is not into this lines or these lines, so then you have to count the small lines. Okay. And that one will represent that how much centimeter the length of the object is. Okay, so try this is also given. So here you can do this, measure the following nearest centimeter or half centimeter. So if by using the scale you can measure, and then I have done here. So yeah, 3.5 centimeter I got. So you just measure this pencil and write it here. Okay. And students, 3.5 can also be written as 3.5. Okay, half means 0.5. okay. Now here it is written that measuring length from different points. Okay, suppose it is not measured from zero, then how can we count it? So that one is also very much easy, because you see, as I told you, we have to count the smaller lines. So 10 small lines will be equal to 1 centimeter. Okay, so these lines are called millimeter. Okay, these are smaller than centimeter. So millimeter, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So 10, that one will be equal to 1 centimeter. Okay, again you can count. Okay. So, if it is equal to 20 millimeter, then it will be equal to 2 centimeter. Okay, so in this way, these rings, these needles, you have to see, you have to count the lines, and accordingly you have to write the measure of these objects. So, similar question is given in 10.1 also, students. So, what you have to do, you have to take the scale and you have to measure it and you have to write it here. So, either if you are not getting exactly the centimeter, so here it is written that measure to the nearest centimeter or half centimeter. Okay. So, if it is between two numbers, so you will write half of that number, and if it is exactly on that number, so you can write that number. Okay, and here it is given that measure the length of the red line. So you can see your book, this red line mark. Okay, so you have to just measure it and then plus it, and then you can get the exact measurement. So here one I have done here. So this is for your example. So it is not like you have to, you also have to get this 3 centimeter only. For showing only, I have just shown you here. Okay, for example, I have shown you here. So for example, this part is your 1 centimeter. So I have written 1 centimeter, and this part is 2 centimeter. So together, if we plus them, we'll get the full length of the red line. Similarly, for this also you have to do. Now, first estimate the length of these lines, and then you have to measure to check whether your estimation is correct or not. So students, you see this line. So after looking at this line, what type of estimation, like how much you can estimate. So your estimation you have to write here, and after that actual length you have to write here. So for me, like it will be near about 7 centimeters. So I have written here 7 centimeters. Now after estimation, you, like all the lines you have to estimate first, and then you have to write it here. And after estimation, you see how much accurate you are. Okay. So how can you see that? By measuring the line, and then you can write the actual measurement here. Okay. So students, you can try this. So this 10.1 is a homework for you students. So you do it in your book only. No need to write it in copy, because space are given already. Okay, so you can do it in your book and tell me if you have any doubt. Okay, thank you.